Welcome to the Beyond the Press channel. Today I'm going to do lathe video. I am turning the Mashinator piston with the medium size lathe behind there. And then we have really interesting work with the giant lathe. So I'm going to film that first. And then tomorrow I will continue with this. So this is like video about 2 days. So we are now here in Helsinki, our merch store, and we have some new merch. This is my absolute favorite. Nelly the Cat t-shirt and hoodies. And we have also a couple other really nice designs. And now for this month, every product, every t-shirt, hoodie or whatever you order, you get one real crushed coin and certificate that's real coin crushed by our press. So we are repairing this giant roll, which has like 4-ended thread there, and it's pretty long. And we have already machined this end and the outer diameter, which you can see here. And now we are going to machine the thread itself. And we have really high-tech setup. We have vacuum cleaner to suck all the plastic shit out, so we don't have to breathe it. And then we have homemade mill head for the lathe. So there is just a big AC motor, and then bearing unit and belt drive here. And I have put the like proper safety precautions there myself, so it's completely okay. And there is like regular milling tool there, and when we plug the motor on, it starts to spin, and the like program box of the lathe, it doesn't know shit about the tool spinning, but it doesn't have to know. It's just doing the business with like regular turning tool, and we can go like really slowly and do the whole thread in one go. We don't have to take like really small amount with one pass and try to go fast. And yeah, we do quite a lot of these and it seems to be working really well. And this is always the most exciting part. Will the connection between this side of the thread and this side of the thread, is it going to be good? And this is from quite large paper machine, because this is just the middle part of the whole roll, and we have two other parts here, so they have already also been machined from this outer diameter, and they are waiting for the milling part. So it's going to be really goddamn big. Yeah, so there was that. The mill pits got maybe a bit too dull on the end of the work, but everything else went really well, and just some slight polishing, and it's really good end result. And now back to the Mashinator. I had done some work off camera. I have machined the piston like pipe, and now I'm going to weld plug on both ends. This is the like upper end, so it's not going to hit, so it doesn't have to be that strong. And this is the head is that is going to do the smashing, so there's a bit more steel there. And I'm welding it quite well there. And the weld isn't going to take the load, it's the like steel against steel, so it hasn't to be anything too crazy the weld, just to like not to start crack after like many impacts. And then I'm going to throw the piece into the lathe, and I'm going to use the was that 3-point support bearing to hold it, because it's so long piece and it doesn't fit inside of the lathe chuck, so it's going to hang quite much out, and without this support it would be probably just fly away. And I add some oil there, because there's also always some friction between the support bearings and the piece. And then I just do some cleaning on the end, and I also make some room, because I'm going to make like plastic rings that are going to glide against the pipe, the like the cylinder pipe. So I'm going to make some room for those, and then I'm going to make the actual hit head like 5 or 10 millimeters smaller than the pipe is, because when we start to hammer things, I think it's going to spread a little bit. So I have to have some room there for it to spread. And then I'm going to just straighten the end, so it's going to hit even all the way and doesn't make any weird forces to sideways or anything like that. And when that's ready, I take my 3-point support away and put the piece back. And then I'm going to use the another support bearing that holds from the end. There is like little center hole on the piece that I can use to support it. And then I'm going to machine the outside diameter from this. It's now exactly the same as the cylinder pipe, but there has to be some clearance, because steel doesn't glide against steel that well. So I decide to take 1 millimeter out of diameter away. So then there is a 0.5 millimeter gap between the piston and the pipe. So it moves pretty well, but when it's almost out and the first plastic glide ring has come out, if it then starts to move sideways, it can't go far, because the steel will like start to glide against steel, and at that point there is so much of speed that it doesn't matter. So it's like, it's not ideal, but if it happens, then it's okay. There isn't too much room for movement. And sorry for all, but this is going to end before the whole thing is done. The GoPro shut off. I didn't do this by meaning. Yeah, but now it's nice and shiny, and then I take it away. And I'm going to now weigh it, because my goal was to do about 20 kilogram piece, and I think it's a little bit heavier. And as we can see, it's almost 30 kilograms, but I think it's pretty good. At least it's going to hit hard. And then I test it there, and it fits nicely. There is that 1 millimeter clearance, or 0.5 millimeter. And I tried to push it out with air gun, but there wasn't enough air from the air gun without those plastic rings that are going to be much tighter fit. But yeah, that's how it's going to work. And we are going to film on next week the Mashinator videos, and I have only the plastic rings to do. And I think we are going to have some kind of test video on next Thursday. And then the official Mashinators videos are coming on beginning of the next month. Yep, but I think this Mashinator is going to be a really nice machine, and it's really nice to see it come together. And yeah, I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day.